Nebuchadnezzar is slain and the kingdom of Babylon is divided. Daniel 5:1 And Nebuchadnezzar the king made a great feast to his god Bel, with about 1,000 of his lords, and they drank wine before their god which was called Bel El Shaddai, which means, God is great, or, Baal is great, or, the Almighty God, or Bel or Baal or God is great. Daniel 5:2 And while Nebuchadnezzar and his guest feasted and tasted the wine, at the feast for Bel El Shaddai, Bel El Shaddai, then Nebuchadnezzar, commanded his servants them to go and bring the gold and the silver vessels, which were dedicated to Elu'hymn, the sovereign one of our forefathers. And the servants of Nebuchadnezzar went to get the sanctified vessels, which they had taken from out of the temple which was in the city of Rome, who was before times called the city of Jerush and Alam, and which was then called Jerusalem. And the other kings were there with their princesses, and they were there with Nebuchadnezzar, who was with his concubines. And they drank wine from them that night. Daniel 5:3 And then they brought the golden vessels that were taken from out of the temple of the house of Elu'hymn, which was from the city of Jerush and Alam, and the king and his princess, and his wives, and his concubines, they drank from them. Daniel 5:4 And they all drank their wine, and they praised their gods of gold and of silver, and of brass, and of iron and of wood, and of stone. Daniel 5:5 Then in that same hour, he came and he wrote upon the wall and upon the plaster that was over against the candlesticks. And it was the fingers of Elu'hymn's Ahiman hand, that appeared only when Elu'hymn had wrote upon the wall that was over against the candlesticks, when he wrote upon the plaster of the wall of the king's palace. And the king Nebuchadnezzar only saw the part of the hand of Elu'hymn's hands that wrote on the wall. Daniel 5:6 Then the king's countenance was changed, and his thoughts troubled him, so that the joints of his loins were loosed, and his knees smote on one another and against his throne. Daniel 5:7 And then the king cried aloud to bring in the astrologers, the Chaldeans, and the soothsayers, and the king spoke and said to the wise men of Babylon, Whosoever shall read this writing, and tell me the interpretation that's over there, shall be clothed with scarlet, and they shall have a chain of gold about their neck, and shall be the third ruler in the kingdom. Daniel 5:8 Then came in all the king's wise men, but they could not read the writing, nor make known the interpretation to the king that was written there. Daniel 5:9 Then was the statue of the king Nebuchadnezzar god Bel El Shaddai, was troubled, by the presence of he. And then was king Nebuchadnezzar countenance changed when he saw Elu'hymn. And he was greatly troubled at the sight of Elu'hymn. And his lords were astonished. Daniel 5:10 Now the queen, by reason of the screams and the words of the king and his lords, came into the banquet house, and the queen spoke and said, O king, live forever, and let not thy thoughts trouble you, neither let your countenance be changed. Daniel 5:11 There is a man in your kingdom, in whom is the spirit of the Holy One, whom is called E. and Elu'hymn. And he is called Daniel. And in the days of my forefathers he was made master of the magicians, and in whom is enlightenment and understanding and wisdom like the wisdom of the Holy One, whom is called Elu'hymn. I say, let me go and find him, because your astrologers, and your Chaldeans, and soothsayers who are here are not greater than the magician of my forefather, who can interpret E's writing on the plaster and that is upon that wall over, and not even your master of the magicians can. Daniel 5:12 Because only E can. And whom is the sovereign Elu'hymn? Because only he can. And inasmuch as an excellent spirit and knowledge and understanding, for interpreting dreams, and showing of hard sentences, and the dissolving of doubts were found in the same man called Daniel, whom the king named Belshazzar, after the king's god Bel El Shaddai. Now king, let Daniel be called, in and that he may show to him the interpretation. Daniel 5:13 Then was Daniel brought in before the king, and then the king spoke and said to Daniel, Are you that Daniel, who is from the Hebrews' children, whom is from the captivity of Weyadaiyah, whom was brought out of captivity? Daniel 5:14 I have heard of you. And how, that E, the Holy One who is your sovereign, and that the Spirit of E is with you, and that enlightenment and understanding and excellent wisdom is found in you. Daniel 5:15, I have called in the wise men and the astrologers, and they are now before me, and now I have made them to bring you. And you are brought in here before me, that you may read this writing, and then make known to me the interpretation that's on that wall over there, because they could not tell me nor show me, but they believe that you could show me the interpretation of the writing. Daniel 5:16, but haven't I heard of you before? Now I remember you. It was you that make known to me the interpretation, from my vision which I saw in my dream, and when you dissolve my doubts, and now if you can read this writing, and you can make known to me the interpretation, you therefore shalt be clothed with a scarlet robe. And you shall have a chain of gold put around your neck, and you shall be the third ruler in my kingdom. Daniel 5:17, then Daniel answered the king, and he said, before I would, but not now. Thank you, King Nebuchadnezzar. Let your gifts go to another, and you can give them my rewards too. Yet I will read the writing from me, which is from my sovereign king. And he will make it be known to me. And I will then make the interpretation known to you. Daniel 5:18, O King Nebuchadnezzar, the Most High One, whom is sovereign of the heavens and the earth, gave you, Nebuchadnezzar, your father's kingdom, and he gave you majesty and glory and honor. Daniel 5:19, and because of the majesty that he gave you, all people, even in all the nations, and even from every languages, and they even trembled now because they feared you, and whom you would slow, and whom you have kept alive, and whom you would set up, and whom you would have put down. Daniel 5:20, but when your heart was lifted up, and your mind was hardened in pride, Elu'hymn deposed you from this kingly throne, and they took your glory from you. Daniel 5:21, and you was driven from the sons of men, and your heart was made like the beasts, and your dwelling place was with the wild asses, and they fed you with grass like an oxen, and your body was wet with the dew of heaven, until you knew that the Most High, whom is called E, ruled in the kingdom of men, and that only E have the power to appoint a head over it, and to give it to whomsoever that E will. Daniel 5:22, and now you, Nebuchadnezzar, his son, O Nebuchadnezzar, you still have not humbled your heart, though you knew, E. And you also knew all of this, Daniel 5:23, but you have lifted up yourself against the Sovereign One of the heavens and the earth, and you have brought the vessels from out of the house of, E, that are now before you, and that you and your lords, and your wives and your concubines them, for them to desecrate them and to drink wine from them, and to which all of you have done, and you all have praised your gods of silver, and gold, of brass and iron, and wood and stone, which do not see nor hear, nor which knows nothing. And the very Sovereign One, in whose hand very breath is in, and in whose hands your are and even all of your ways, you have not praised, nor have you given your worship, nor have you reverence, E. Nor have you given to Elu'hymn any thanksgiving nor any glorification. Daniel 5:24, then the part of E's hand that you saw was the hand of E, who came to you, and who have written this writing that you now have seen. Daniel 5:25, and this is the writing that was written, Mene, Tekel v-Pharsin. Daniel 5:26, and this is the interpretation of the writing of E, Mene, your kingdom was numbered, and your kingdom, and it is now finished. Daniel 5:27, Tekel, and he has weighed your life in the balances, and your life is now found wanting. Daniel 5:28, Paris, and your kingdom shall be divided, and it shall be given to the Medes and Persians. Daniel 5:29, then the king Nebuchadnezzar commanded that they should clothe Belshazzar, whom is also called Daniel, with scarlet robe, and to put a chain of gold about his neck, and to make a proclamation concerning him, that he should be the third ruler in the kingdom. Daniel 5:30, but in that same night, before Belshazzar could be anything, the king of the Chaldeans slay King Nebuchadnezzar, who was about 62 years old. Daniel 5:31, and Darius the Chaldean king. And the king of the Median took his kingdom. Friends, if you have come to realize that we are today are like Nebuchadnezzar in this story and we all are worshipping Baal, who is also called Baal, and God, and the Almighty God. And we are enthusiastically serving and worshipping and lauding and praising God, and we are even giving Him our thanksgiving every day. But we have forgotten the true sovereign of the heavens and the earth, whom is called and Elu'hymn, and Ahiman, and Elu'yah. And we're giving out praises to Gog God, whom is called Godreel and Satan. Friends, it's not too late to return to Elu'hymn. If you now see the need to accept and to embrace Elu'hymn and Ahiman and Elu'yah, would pray and ask to save you and your family and your loved one? Friend, if you would you please say this simple prayer? O Elu'hymn, whom is also called Ahiman and Elu'yah, I now believe in your sacred name. Please save me. Thank you. Amen. The end, to be continued.